On August 15th, 2023, Ingalls Shipbuilding, a division of HII, successfully launched the U.S. Navy's latest Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer named Ted Stevens, DDG-128. This is the second Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer to be built in the Flight III configuration. As per its commanding officer, Captain Mary Katey Hays, it will be the most advanced and powerful ship of its kind in the U.S. Naval Fleet and the world once it sets sail. Captain Hays stated that the destroyer has the best of everything: the most advanced weapons, the fastest computers, the best radar, and the most advanced anti-submarine warfare gear. Viewers may note that Flight III is the fourth flight upgrade in the 30-plus year history of the class and is preceded by Flight 1, 2, and 2A. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why USS Ted Stevens is touted to be the most powerful destroyer in the world. Let's get started. The Arleigh Burke-class ships became the U.S. Navy's only active destroyers until the Zumwalt-class became active in 2016. The Arleigh Burke-class has the longest production run for any post-World War II U.S. Navy surface combatant. The class is named for Admiral Arleigh Burke, an American destroyer officer in World War II and later Chief of Naval Operations. Arleigh Burke-class warships are designed to be capable of performing multiple missions. These can carry out anti-aircraft warfare, AAW, anti-submarine warfare, ASW, and anti-surface warfare, ASUW. The warship is named after Theodore Fulton Stevens Sr., who was an American politician and lawyer and served as a U.S. Senator from Alaska from 1968 to 2009. He was the longest-serving Republican senator in history at the time he left office. Captain Hays stated that a mighty vessel like the DDG-128 Arleigh Burke-class destroyer being named after Stevens is a fitting honor for such a legendary personality. Hays also mentioned Stevens' dedication to the Navy, the country, and the people of Alaska. The Arleigh Burke-class of guided missile destroyer is the United States Navy's first class of destroyer to be built from the ground up to incorporate the Aegis combat system. The Aegis ballistic missile defense system is designed by the United States Department of Defense, the Missile Defense Agency, to protect against short and intermediate range ballistic missiles. Aegis ballistic missile defense is devised to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and prior to re-entry. It will enable USS Ted Stevens to shoot down enemy ballistic missiles. The Flight III upgrade is centered on Raytheon Technologies and SPY 6V1 radar, which is also known as Air and Missile Defense Radar, AMDR. This is a major upgrade compared to ANSPY 1. The four fixed arrays of SPY direct electromagnetic beams in all directions concurrently and continuously, so the targets are tracked without interruption. The radar can be made to focus on a single target when needed, without blinding the warship against other threats. The new radar is designed to help ships track missile and aircraft threats at farther ranges while maintaining resilience to noise and other forms of interference. It's estimated to have a 15 dBi improvement compared to the previous generation ANSPY 1 radar, or capable of detecting targets half the size at twice the distance. So roughly it's four times more powerful. This enables the radar to create a very holistic view of the surrounding, providing unprecedented situational awareness. USS Ted Stevens will be one of the most massively armed destroyers in the world. The warship will have in total 96 cell Mark 41 vertical launch system, VLS, divided into two blocks of 32 and 64 cells. These are capable of launching a variety of missiles, including Tomahawk, standard missiles 2, 3, and 6, ESSM blocks 1 and 2, as well as RUM-139A VL ASROC. It will also have two Mark 141 Harpoon missile launchers for the anti-ship role. Two Mark 32 triple torpedo tubes will be present for launching Mark 46 or Mark 50 torpedoes. USS Ted Stevens will carry two MH-60R Seahawk helicopters in its double hangar and helipad, enhancing its aviation capabilities. Other than these, it's equipped with an upgraded 5-inch diameter gun for surface warfare and land attack, a 20mm Phalanx Close-In Weapons System, CIWS, two 25mm Mark 38 machine gun systems, and four 50 caliber 12.7mm guns. Arleigh Burke-class warships have seen many incremental upgrades and have been able to include several key additions. Flight III includes modifications such as an upgraded fire extinguishing system, new ship service turbine generators, additional transformers, and power conversion modules. Structural changes have also been made to increase reserve buoyancy, lower the ship's center of gravity, and enhance overall strength. Apart from the self-defense features, the ship provides improved ballistic protection for magazines and vital spaces. It also contains various installed and portable damage control, firefighting, and dewatering systems intended to enhance survivability and recovery from battle damage. USS Ted Stevens will be capable of fighting multiple air, surface, and subsurface threats simultaneously, as well as conducting peacetime presence, crisis management, sea control, and power projection activities. The important aspect is the Arleigh Burke-class is versatile, and since they're present in a decent number, they provide a lot of flexibility to the U.S. Navy. This has great strategic significance, as the U.S. is now facing a very assertive China and unpredictable Russia.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.